right. Hello. Today we're going to explore how fractions and division are related. Let's look at the first example. Three apples are shared equally among four people. So how would you write this as a fraction? Would you write four on top or would you write three on top? Let's look and see the different options here. Let's look at the meaning of what is going on here. Are we sharing the four people? Are we sharing the three apples? If you write it this way, this is four people shared among three apples. Now that doesn't make sense, does it? You can't share four people. Apples are not going to eat the people. So that doesn't make sense. Look at this option. Three apples are shared equally among four people. Correct. All right, so this is your correct way to write this problem. And this is actually, do you see these words right here, shared equally? I hope that these are clue words and this triggers your memory in knowing that this is actually division clue words. Three apples shared equally among four people can be written also as division. This is three divided by four. And 3/4 means three divided by four. Okay, so if we wanted to look at this on a number line and just show like what, where would this actually lie on the number line? Let's look at what it would look like. We know that 3/4, four is your denominator. So let's put a number, draw a number line with four equal sections. 1/4, 2/4, 3/4, and of course, 1/2 is the same as 4/4. And 3/4 would land right here. So you can see that 3/4 is between the whole number 0 and the whole number 1. So it lies between 0 and 1. Okay, so let's look at another example. Okay, so let's look at this other example. Eight children want to share 49 sheets of construction paper. You see this clue word, share, and you know that this is a clue word for division. You're going to want to write this in fraction form because that means the same thing. Fractions and division are the same thing. So how do you write it? Do you say 8 divided by 49, or do you write 49 divided by 8? So let's look at this particular fraction. What is the meaning of this? This is 8 children divided by 49 sheets of construction paper. Now that's just absolutely absurd, right? 49 sheets of construction paper to be shared, 8 children to be shared among 49 sheets, that makes no sense. So look at this example. This one is 49 sheets of construction paper shared equally among the 8 students. Are you noticing a pattern? The people always have to be on the bottom. You're not going to share people, right? So you're sharing the objects among the people. So here is your correct fraction. This one does not make sense. All right, so what does this mean? 49/8. So we know that 49 divided by 8 is the meaning of 49/8, okay? We could come over here and just make this into also a division problem, like long division. 49 always goes in the house first, 49 divided by 8. How many times will 8 go into 49? 6 times. 6 times 8 is 48. Subtract and get 1. Now let's interpret what this means. And let's change this back into a mixed number. This will mean 6 is your whole number. And 1 becomes the numerator, and 8 is your denominator. So 6 and 1/8. Okay, so we can show this on a number line, and let's put a 6 here, and let's put the whole number 7 here, and show that where the 6 and 1/8 would actually fall. Now we know that the denominator is going to be 8, okay, that stays the same. And let's double check that this is 8s, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And you could label all the way across. This would be 6 and 1/8. This is 6 and 2/8 and so forth, 6 and 3/8 and so forth. But here is where your number is going to fall, 6 1/8. Now, do you notice your whole number 6 and 7? So your answer of 49/8 lies between the whole number 6 and the whole number 7. Okay? So I hope that makes sense.